So, we learned about breathing in other animals, right? In the last class, we learned about breathing in other animals. So, before that, we learned why should this animal should breathe, right? Why animals should breathe?
They also want to get energy.
Okay, there is no other source to get energy for this animal. So from the food only, they can also get the energy. By the breakdown of food, they also may get the energy. For breaking down of food, what is necessary? What is needed? Breakdown of food?
Oxygen.
Very, very good, friend. Oxygen in the absence of oxygen also, maybe that is somewhat special cases, but almost energy is released in the presence of oxygen. So if it is in the presence of oxygen, there should be a breathing organ, right? In a human being, like other animals, elephants, lion, goats, frogs, lizards, snakes, birds, these all are breathing through their lungs. Okay, breathing through their lungs. So I think you all learned about it. Did we inform about frogs?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. What is specialty about frog?
They breathe
through the water.
Okay, one can. Who is ready to say the answer? Raise your hand. Yes, Afreen. One more chance for Afreen today.
Ma'am, under the water, the frog can breathe through its skin.
Very good.
It can use its lungs.
Okay, so as it is an amphibian, means animals that live both
water and land,
and also on land. They need to breathe during when they are in water and also when they are in land. So here they are using the lungs on land. And what about it? The skin. Skin on the, when it is there in the water. Okay. So here, second one you can see it. Frog is an animal which can breathe through lungs as well as its moist skin. And other organism that breathes through skin, it is earthworm. I think that also we had discussed it, right?
Yes, ma'am.
And I told about an article related to earthworm in the Wynots, right? So due to the climatic condition, when the temperature increases, the earthworm can't leave. They may become dry up. If their skin is dry up, means they can't breathe it. Only through their moist skin that the earthworm and the frog can breathe. Okay, so I think that much we finish. And next one, yes, breathing underwater. The organisms that lives underwater, how do they breathe? That is what we want to learn. So when we talk about an organism that it is in underwater, means it is mainly fish. Okay, so fish, the animals living underwater have not only fish, so many are there. Gills are for breathing. What is the name of the organ that used to breathe?
Gills.
Is for breathing underwater. The organisms that live underwater, their breathing organ is gills. G-I-L-L-S. So, this one, gills, what are gills? Gills are projections of the skin. Some skin projection on the skin, that is the gills. Here in the picture, you can see the gills of the fish, right? So, when the fish bring to your house, you can also see that it is very difficult to take the covering out of it. It is very tough, isn't it? So inside you can see some reddish color. They are called gills. The blood vessels are passing through these gills. The blood vessels are passing through these gills. So so the oxygen for the fish also need the oxygen, but they are breathing the oxygen which it is dissolved in water, isn't it? They are breathing oxygen which it is dissolved in water. So when the water passes through the gills, the gills has an ability to extract, to take oxygen from the water, dissolved oxygen from the water. So when the water when it passes through the gills, these gills may extract means they may take out dissolved oxygen from the water. And I told over these gills, what is present over these gills? What is present there on the gills?
Gill cover
is protecting it. Okay. And inside, mm-hmm. over the gills, what is present? Blood vessels. Okay, blood vessels are spreading on the gills. So when the gills take the oxygen from the water, that oxygen is taken to the blood vessels. That oxygen is taken to the blood vessels. These blood vessels may go through all over the body of it. So it can give the oxygen to all of its cells. In that cell, in the presence of oxygen, the glucose may break down to produce energy and also carbon dioxide. So once the carbon dioxide is produced, what we need to do? Yes, what we need to do? Once the carbon dioxide is produced, we should take it out, right? We have to remove that carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide is a poison. So we have to remove carbon dioxide. So the blood vessels which are there on the cells, they may take the carbon dioxide back and they may help to expel, get out this carbon dioxide from the gills. This is the story. Sneha, are you playing? Sneha? So here, I will repeat it. So what is the name of the breathing organ in organisms under water?
Gills.
Okay, gills. Especially on fish, the breathing organ is gill. So what did these gills may do? What is their function? What they are doing?
Help them to take breath.
Suraja?
Help them to breathe in water.
Okay, help them to breathe. After that, I told one more important point.
And the blood
helps them to use oxygen
released in water. Help the fish to use oxygen dissolved in water. How they are? And how, Sneha, and how they are doing it? How they are doing it?
Gills are special ability to extract water and oxygen.
Sorry, Ahmad Afridi?
Gills have an ability that can...
Ability to extract or to water. Take out dissolved, very good. Dissolved oxygen from the water. That is the main point. Okay, so organism that lives under water, their breathing organ is gills, first point. Okay, especially for fish also, breathing organ is gills. Clear? So let me ask question. Gautam Krishna? Yes. What is the name of the breathing organ in organism that lives under water? Okay, tell me the spelling.
I-N-N-S.
First, not heard properly.
G-I-N-N-S.
Okay, these gills are present at the both side of the head. Okay, of their head. That is there. It is covered by a, it is protected by a tough cover. And see, what are these gills doing when the water get into the this one gills? What they may do? Nakul? Nakul? Yeah. When the water passes through the gills, what is the function of the gills?
The gills extract the oxygen from the water.
Okay, very good. Yes, Baja? Baja? Not clear. I can't hear you. Can you tell me once again?
She's saying someone is in the waiting room.
Okay, okay. Okay, okay. Yes, I admitted. Room. I admitted. Yes, yes. Okay. So here, what all other things that is all exchange of gases, right? Through the gills, oxygen will get into the body and the blood vessels are spreading all over the gills and all over the body of the fish. So this, through the blood vessel, the oxygen is passed to the different cells. And cells may undergo breakdown of food and may release energy and also carbon dioxide. This carbon dioxide, again, through the blood cell, it may expel out of the body through the gills. Okay? Is it clear? Any doubt? Is it clear, children? Yes or no? Okay, okay. So here we can see some other examples of animal organism that undergo this type of respiration. Prawns, crab, prawns, right? N is there, right? Okay, prawns, crab, and freshwater mussel are also respired through gills. And here in the second picture, you can see in the first picture, gills are inside. But this type of fish, these are the gills. They are projected outward. Can you see it? No? Projected outward. Some of the fish like salamander. Salamander, have you heard about salamander?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So this type of fish, freshwater fish, right? Salamander. So these type of fish have the gills out of their body. Not only that, larvae of frogs. See, in the life cycle of frog, larvae are there. From the eggs, larvae are coming out of it, right? So that larvae are respiring through this way. Their gills are out of the body. Okay, so these are the example for animals that where the gills are out of their body. Some type of fish like salamander, larvae or frogs like. And all the other have this type of gills inside. And another important thing, like dolphin, whales and all, you can see some holes on their head. Okay, so these holes are called blowholes, B-L-O-W-H-O-L-E-S. Blowholes means through that they don't have gills. Dolphins, whales, sharks, they don't have gills. But instead of it, they have two holes on their head. Through the hole... Yes, Afridi.
Then may Aristar eyes.
Where is the?
Then where is their eyes?
Eyes, okay. Eyes are on the side of the body. So here we can see the, on their head. On their head, you can see the two holes. Okay, yes, if it is possible, I will show that picture also. So here, why they have holes instead of the gills? So they need a lot of, their body is very big, they need a lot of oxygen. So in order to get oxygen, they have two holes. So through the hole, the oxygen, and not only that, they may come out in between, they may come out of the surface of water. Have you seen dolphins are jumping? Why they are jumping frequently on from
the catch the oxygen?
To get the oxygen, because their respiratory system is somewhat different. So if they come out of the water, only they will get the oxygen which is there in the atmosphere. So through the hole, the oxygen will get into their body, and the respiration take place. So in order to get the oxygen, whales and dolphins are frequently coming out of the water. Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Is it clear? Neuralia, are you playing there? Okay, so this is all about the breathing in organism under water. Next one, we can see the breathing in insects. Okay, breathing in the insect, like cockroach, grasshopper, mosquitoes, houseflies, bees, wasps, like this insect, how they are breathing. So before going to that, I will show some pictures. One insect, one worm, right? This is also the picture of an insect. So here you can see small holes on the side of the body or at the back side of the body, abdominal side of the body. You can see small holes there. Can you see it here in this one?
Yes.
These are small side holes on the side of that worm. And here also you can see holes there, right? So gas enters and leaves the tracheal system through the spirit. That I will tell you. Okay. These holes are called spiracles. Spiracles. The holes that present on the side or the abdominal place of the insects are called spiracles. Instead of gills. As gills are for underwater animal, spiracles are for insects. What is the name of the organ? What is the name of the organ that help the insect to breathe?
Spiracles
means a tiny holes that present on the side of the body or at the abdominal place. Okay. So this hole in the third picture, which I am marking, tick marking, you can see some holes here, spiracles here.
Yes,
can you see the spiracles? I have marked it. Some small yes, holes. See, under this spiracles, can you see some pipe-like structure, children?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, okay. So, this through the holes, through the spiracles, the oxygen will get into the body. Through the spiracles, through the holes that is present on the side of the body or the abdominal place of the body, the oxygen will get into it. After getting the oxygen into the body through spiracles, this oxygen should reach to the cells, right? How did they reach? That is through some, here, can you see some fiber-like things here all? A network of air tubes are present. Network of air
system.
That you can see it only on the third picture. In the first two pictures, you can't see it. So here, this is the one of the air tube. Here all you can see, so network of air tubes are there. This network of air tubes are all ever around the, all together, all over the body of the insect. That is called trachea. That is called trachea. Have you heard this word before? Trachea. Anywhere you heard?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, where you heard it?
Windpipe.
Yeah, another name of the windpipe. Yes, in our windpipe, another name of the windpipe is. Yes, yeah. Another name of the windpipe is this trachea. Okay, so here in the same way, air tubes, holes are there. That holes are called spiracles. Connected to that spiracles, some air tube, network of air tubes are present in the body of insect. That air tubes are called
trachea.
Very good, Albin. Very good. Okay. That air tubes are called trachea. So two organs are there for the insect. One, spiracle, holes. And the second one, air tubes, trachea. Got it?
Yeah.
Okay. So breathing in insect. All the insects have tiny holes on the sides of their body, which are called spiracles. So here you can expect two questions. Sneha?
Yes, ma'am.
What is the name of the breathing organ on the organ on in insects?
Spiracles.
Okay, spiracles. Next question. Yes, effins. Unmute fast. What is the unmute, dear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, very good. What is the name of the holes on the sides of the body of insects?
Trachea.
Holes on the sides of the insect, body of insect. Holes on the sides of the body of insect.
Spiracles.
Spiracles. So say it confidently. Let me ask question once again. FN, what is the name of the holes on that present on the sides of the body of insect?
Spiracles.
Okay, write and study the spelling. Okay, next one, Adinath. Okay, now, yes, Adinath, can you hear me, Adinath? Okay, so Rinan?
Yes.
What is the name of the network of air, thin air tubes in the body of insect?
Trachea.
Okay, trachea, not trachea, that is trachea. Okay, trachea. Nasreen, what is the name of the network of thin air tube present in insect?
Trachea.
Okay. So, one more question. Akash, can you switch on the video? Akash. So many videos are off when I am sharing. So many are switching off the videos. Okay. So, my question is, Gautam, Ahmed Afridi, Gauri Priya, Nihan, switch on the videos fast. So, Akash, what is the name of the breathing organ in insect? Though if I ask question to those students who are sitting without videos, they can't answer my question. Yes. What is the name of the breathing organ that present in insect? Hasher. Yes, Hasher.
Yes, ma'am.
Who can say this answer? I can't say it.
Yes, ma'am. Spiracles.
Spiracles. And one more.
Trachea.
Okay. Both are connected. Spiracles are taking oxygen and giving it to trachea. Trachea is taking that to cells. They are the breakdown of food. Due to that energy produced, carbon dioxide also produced. The tracheas are taking, trachea take this take this carbon dioxide back, and through the spiracles they may expel it out. Okay, so this is how the breathing process that take place in the insects. Who can explain this one? For when I ask like so, first you have to refer the this one, which all are the breathing organ. Then how the process take place in this breathing organ? Who is ready to explain it? Who is ready to explain? Fast. Baja, are you ready, Baja? No, why? Who is ready? Nobody.
Can you repeat the question?
Yes. Who is ready to explain about the process of respiration in insect? Nothing to say. First to say about the breathing organ. Nasreen, I think Nasreen will tell. Right, Nasreen? Which all are the breathing organs that present in insect?
Spiracles.
And
trachea.
Trachea, okay. And who can add to it? What will happen to spiracle? What will happen to trachea?
Yes, ma'am, I can.
Adinath. Yes, Adinath.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, all the insects have tiny holes on the poles of their body, which they are called spiracles. The spiracles are connected to the network of the air tubes called the trachea.
Okay. So how the exchange of gases take place? Who can say how the exchange of gases take place? Amrita? Yes. What did happen to spiracle? First to start with there.
Spiracles.
Yes. From the atmosphere. From the atmosphere. Unmute, dear.
They take the oxygen.
From spiracles.
Then?
To the oxygen. When they...
Gopika, Parvati, anybody can help Amrita?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
From the atmosphere, spiracle taking the oxygen and give trachea. From trachea, it goes to the cells, and in cells, breakdown of food happens, and carbon dioxide is released.
Energy is produced.
And from there, it goes to
through the trachea, it may expel out of the body through spiracles. Very easy one, right? Who can? Suraja, can you do a try? Suraja, not able. Okay. I will come back to you. Okay, no problem.
There are so many people here.
That is okay, no problem. Okay, so can you attend the class if so many people are there?
I can hear you. I can't hear them because I am wearing headphones. What they tell you can hear now.
Okay, Gopika Shankar. I hope no other guests are there, right? So you can see the answer.
Yeah. No, ma'am, I just joined. There was a problem with Zoom.
Okay. What about Nakul? Akash is not of this class, no? Nakul?
Yes, ma'am, can you repeat the question?
Okay, I will explain, okay? After that, see here, we are explaining about breathing in insect. All the insects have tiny holes on the sides of their body, which is called spiracles. So the air, the oxygen from the air, get it into the body through these spiracles, through these small holes. First step over through the spiracles. Second, The spiracles are connected to a network of thin air tubes. Thin air tubes called trachea. Network of air tubes called trachea. So second step, through the spiracle, the oxygen is passed to trachea. So the trachea is a network of air tubes. It may take the air to different parts of the body, different cells.
Then expel it.
Yeah. There it may break down the food and release carbon dioxide and energy. That energy is used up by the insect and the carbon dioxide is again taken by the trachea. So third step, respiration over. Fourth step, trachea is taking the carbon dioxide. From the trachea, this carbon dioxide may go to the out of the body, goes out of the body through the spiracles. Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Is there any doubt?
No, ma'am.
Okay. Okay, I think
the tiny holes are outside the body, right? So the oxygen.
Yes, somebody is talking.
Yes, ma'am. The spiracles are outside the body of insects, right?
Yes, holes. That outside. Hole is called spiracle. That hole is called spiracle. So in the same way, I showed some holes on the veils, right? That holes also called spiracles. Okay. That holes also we can call spiracles. The holes on the veils. See, these holes, blow holes are also called. And if you are searching, you can find referring it as spiracles. Spiracles is the name given to the holes that is present on the body of insect or the veils. Mm? And cockroach, grasshopper, mosquitoes, houseflies, bees, wasps, these all have these type of breathing organs. So, Hasher, can you tell me what is the breathing organ in mosquitoes? Are you seeing mosquitoes? Not seeing. That also not seeing. Who can say? Raise your hand. Gopika Shankar.
And spiracles.
Spiracles and trachea. Okay. Spiracles and also trachea. So up to